But let's just make it our video to Patrick Stump.
Yeah, this is dedicated. What this if he really watches it?
Oh, this is our video to Patrick Stump. We want him to know that even when he had his mutton chops, we still really liked him.
That's when I started liking him.
See,
so I don't know
Lauren has a thing for guys with mutton chops.
No, just one person.
Just
no
one, and that's you, Patrick. Today is the Fall Out Boy concert with my sister that I got tickets for. My sister's going to pick me up really soon. We're going to Salt Lake to see them tonight at 7 for my birthday present. That was clear back in March. So sweet. So Lauren's and Dad are finally here because Dad took forever. So we're finally going to leave.
Heck yeah.
We're going to Fall Out Boy. That's all.
That's all. Okay.
I don't know what else. We are on our way to...
Hey, I got you too. We're on our way to the Fall Out Boy concert.
Hey, we are on our way to the concert. I'm waiting for Lauren. She's in the bathroom.
Lost the key.
That's not good.
I'm sitting on it.
Got myself some Mountain Dew, and we're gonna, sing some songs.
Just wanna notify everyone of all of these bobbleheads, chihuahua bobbleheads. Okay. I don't want the person to come out. There's like literally 20.
It's good. It's good stuff. That's the lady.
Also tried every stall in the bathroom, even though there was a line.
What the
lady
heck?
Did. She went to every single one. I'm like, there's a line for a reason.
Well, she's got her chihuahuas. She may have some problems, but she's got her chihuahuas to cope.
Shout out to Tony. We just sang I Don't Care For You, Man. Because that's the only song he likes by Fall Out Boy. Because we did it in a pep band. I'm wearing my slip-ons and Sunday socks. But let's just make it our video to Patrick Stump.
Yeah, this is dedicated. What this if he really watches it?
Oh, this is our video to Patrick Stump. We want him to know that even when he had his mutton chops, we still really liked him.
That's when I started liking him.
See, Lauren has a thing for guys with mutton chops.
No, just one person.
Just one, and that's you, Patrick.
The only person.
Anything you want to tell him?
I just stood in an awkward bathroom line for 15 minutes.
Yeah. You know, Patrick, how many windows I washed for you? I washed like 12 windows. One of them was really high on him. Fell off twice.
And then he broke his iPod.
And then I broke my iPod, which is pretty unrelated to coming here, but...
Oh, I see.
So, for you, Patrick.
It's your song.
We're not actually gonna sing, we're just gonna lip sync, and I don't know it very well. This song is also dedicated to Matt Denhalter, who almost won an argument with my mom over it, so... They were arguing on whether it was the Pulp Fiction theme or the Addams Family theme.
It's
the Munsters, so Dad almost won, but he didn't. Okay. Better luck next time, Matt.
Still giving you a shout out though, so. USB.
Dance like Uma Thurman, bury me till I confess. you'll never leave this town. Cause you're just a girl all the boys wanna dance with, and I'm just a boy who's had too many chances. Sleeping on your folks, once again dreaming. She said, why don't you just come get out of here? Jetpack blues, just like Judy, the kind that leaves June feel like September. I'm the last one that you'll ever remember, and I'm trying.
I don't know this one as well as all the other, every other one, in case you're watching, Patrick.
I know this, Patrick, because we played it in the pep bands.
Say my name and it's in the same breath.
Patrick, I'm obviously a bigger Fall Boy fan because I do that.
Who's been just the fan since she was
okay,
six?
Okay, Lauren's a bigger fan than I am. But hey, Patrick, listen.
Look at this. They must have known we were such good friends.
So, what's the drummer's name? I want to talk to him for a while, but I don't know his name.
No, what is... Duh, you should. He was on One Tree Hill.
The drummer was?
Yeah. You dated Peyton.
For reals. Good for you, man.
Oh, wait.
He has a drum solo tonight.
Maybe not. Wait, who's the one that... Who's, like, the one that everyone knows?
Pete Wentz.
Yeah.
Pete Wentz is the bassist.
Sorry, Pete. I'm actually just a fan of Patrick.
Mostly. I like Pete.
Because I've had a crush on him and his sideburns since I was...
Pete's a bisexual, you know.
12.
Pete's the one that showed his penis on the internet.
No, we're not putting that on the show. On the jump.
Was not
a yo-yo. It was a tobacco grinder, right?
But it looked like a yo-yo. Like, I'm pretty sure you were like, yeah, when I said I want
to. Well, I said they have yo-yos, and then I looked up, and then by the time I looked up,
the guy said, oh, I thought it was a yo-yo too. Like, he thought it was
a yo-yo. He did. He was also very white and very Mormon. Yes. Yes, we did.
Then
he was good. He was really good.
He was good. He was good live.
He was surprisingly good, actually.
Yeah, he's dancing a lot, and he took off his shirt.
He did do that.
He was rapping. And he said the F word a lot, because he did not care one bit.
No.
A girl threw up in front of us.
And the set list was 100% accurate.
I was right. My sources were trustworthy.
Then karma kicked in and we had to take further back seats.
So what happened was, so earlier in the concert when Wiz was performing, he had to like run up this aisle that was like close to where we were sitting.
Yeah.
But like, and we couldn't run over to the edge of the aisle because there's like nobody in those seats. Could run over to the edge of the aisle.
Okay, yeah, so let's explain this situation though. So there is a middle, like a stage in the middle of the USANA. So there's like the front stage and then there's like a stage in the middle of like all of it.
There's a mini stage in the middle. And to access it, you run through this you have to run up the side aisle, and it was the side we were on. And it's like, why wouldn't you use that mini stage if you got it? So Wiz used it. And then,
They distract the audience while the band runs.
While Fall Out Boy performing, then they left, and there's two acoustic songs next. We knew because we had that set list. So then, and then Lauren points, and I immediately just run over to the side because then I see them.
And I had to stay with all of our items.
And
that
I
were
was
on the ground.
I was still zoomed in on my camera, so you can't really see the first time I jump over, run over. And Pete high fived me. Well, it was more like just like a. Like that.
I touched Pete Wentz. I touched Pete Wentz. I touched him. He high-fived me.
Shut up. I had to stay with our freaking stuff.
Oh, but my camera was zoomed in.
Are you serious?
But then
hey, we have to go get a high five.
So, which, by the way, the acoustic part was awesome.
It was great. I didn't get a lot of film of it because we were waiting.
Yeah, we were trying. Well, we were.
Yeah, we weren't supposed to film any of the concert at all.
Which was actually the band's decision and request, so sorry.
It was?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So this whole video, you'll probably hate it. Because we really hope you see it.
Yeah, but oh my gosh, I am so sorry, Patrick.
I hope that you see that we love you that much.
Yeah, I hope you see
just needed to remember this moment. But also, we won't tell the set list. We just will say that we know the set list and that's all.
Okay, go ahead.
Patrick, I'm gonna touch your hand when you come right through here. I'm going to. And I'm so excited about it.
This lady was like, okay, you can't record, but she was like, you can take photos. And I was like, oh yeah, I'll just take a photo with my video camera. And so,
So then I was just
recording, except really sorry, but it got real blurry right when they ran past.
Which Nick has not been able to get over for a solid.
It is gnawing at my soul.
Patrick, I'm gonna touch your hand!
Intentional though.
I feel like we were recording and he saw.
No, because he high-fived
just
me.
Just kidding.
And the camera was in my hand.
He did. But I got Pete's and
the guitarist.
The guitarist.
But I high-fived Pete twice and Patrick once. It was awesome.
Yeah. I was very sad that I did not. But
Pete's hands were very calloused because he plays the bass.
I did not notice because I did not touch his hands close or long enough.
No, Pete, he got me bad the second time. The first time, but the second time was solid, and Patrick was solid too. It was like this. Just like this, Patrick, he remembers. It sounded like good live.
Yeah, but it was so loud and everybody loved you so much that it was so freaking loud that I couldn't even hear sometimes. And if I didn't know every single word to the songs, then I wouldn't have been able to follow it as well as I had.
But she does.
But I do, so.
Except for I Don't Care, which I knew every word to, and Lauren
didn't.
It's
the only one I don't know very well.
And I sang my heart out. Lauren won't let me drive. I drove for a little while. And
I total of like 8 minutes, and it was terrifying. And I saw my life flash before my eyes.
Okay, whatever.
It was terrifying. So now I'm back to driving.
What was your favorite song in the concert?
I really liked the acoustic ones, but I liked Uma Thurman, even though that's not my favorite song, but I really like it. I liked it live. Yeah.
I'm really trying, really, really freaking trying over here. Someday, the storm clears for everyone, and you realize you can move mountains.
Came out and sang.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Yeah, it was good.
That was cool.
Favorites. It was Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah, we
but they didn't play it. It's okay though. We forgive you, Patrick.
There was also this woman, I know we talked about this for a second, that was dancing. And she was just having the time of her life dancing. She was very intoxicated. And Nick made me film him dancing exactly like her, and it was awful, super funny, but also mean. We were being mean, and everybody behind us saw what we were doing.
Ooh.
I missed it.
Ah.
Oh gosh.
Overall, it was a really good concert. It was
awesome.
It was solid. Oh yeah, and those spins that I wanted Pete to do with his bass, he definitely did it a couple times.
Did you get it on film?
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Like a montage of it.
Yeah, and we paid for premium parking.
Paid for premium parking, which was worth it because we got out of there fast.
Yeah, that was worth it. But I mean, well.
It's the perfect time of day
for like a solid.
In such as this.
I want to be like this big.
It's hard to tell if I exist.
Lindsay McGuire. She can't do it.
The car and leave this.
Yeah.
at an end, but it's been great coming out and seeing people in the crowd who are probably considered outsiders by the rest of the world.
Heck yeah, man. Heck yeah.
Whether you're considered an outsider because of the way you look or dress, or because you smoke weed, or
every day,
because of the way you think, the world only considers you that or calls you that in an attempt to marginalize you.
Marginalized.
And I want to say the greatest thing about that is, as soon as you realize that, as soon as you realize you're only being marginalized, you take that.
Gonna be the shot.
Okay.
On the video.